Well, here in Düsseldorf for the semi-finals of the European Championships for Espoirs 2013. For you who don't know what's going on, semi-finals in the men will be held between the countries of Belgium and Italy on one side. And on the other side, it will be against between France and Denmark. With the ladies, we got two semi-finalists, or four semi-finalists. On the left side, over to our left, we get the matches. Italy against Spain. And on the far right, we can see the match of France against Switzerland. But we're starting up right now. So we will be back in 5 or 10 minutes with some commentary on this match, on these matches, on these semi-finalists. Be right back.
Hi. Thank you. zelfs voor. Bij 9 uur 20, want ik denk dat het leuk was.
All right, good morning everybody. Welcome at the summer finals of the European Championships 2013. Semifinals started at 9 o'clock. Current scores are being updated in the chat window. Paul Kogje is responsible for that. And we thank Paul Kogje for updating the scores. We cannot give you a view of one specific game we decided to try to give you a little bit more overview of what's going on and talk you through what's happening. So we can see something about everything. Here over on the left side, we're viewing the matches. Spain against Italy. Current scores are 9-6 for Spain. And on the far left, we're seeing Denmark playing against France. Maybe a little surprise there, but Denmark is in the lead, 6-2. Obviously, normally speaking, the French should win that game, but Denmark has proven themselves to be very flexible in their game, very positive, and a very good team spirit. They qualified for the semifinals yesterday in the pool with Belgium. A very exciting pool. We wish them all the luck against the French. 6-2 there for Denmark. Over on the right side, we're watching what appears to be the most exciting game of this semifinal. It's the team of Belgium against the team of Italy. Playing there are the best players of both countries. On paper, that is. For Belgium are playing Logan Baton, Dylan Alexandre, and Dieter Verplanken. Playing against the team of Italy. Well-known names, former world champions, juniors, Diego Ricci, Alessandro Basson and Mattia Chiappello. Current scores, Belgium, Italy 1-3. And on the far right side, we're seeing the games. France against Switzerland. Maybe also a little surprise so far. Again, we should reckon that the French should win this game, but the scores are 6-2 for Switzerland. For France are playing Anna Maillard, Morgan Bagon, and Audrey Bandeira. On the left side, the French men have equaled the score with a good round, made 4 points, and the score over there is 6-6. Let's see how Denmark copes with that. Bienvenue pour les spectateurs belgiques et les français. On regarde la demi-finale du championnat d'Europe Espoir 2013. En masculine, la demi-finale 1. C'est un match de le pays France contre le Danemark. Le score là, c'est 6 partout. Après une 6-2 pour Danemark. Pour France, joue Dylan Rocher. Florent Contenson et Williams Dauphin. Bien sûr. Pour Danemark, on joue Matthias Beyer, Daniel Presutti et Morten Junge. L'autre demi-finale, la demi-finale 2 contre avec le pays d'Italie contre La Belgique. Pour l'Italie, on joue Diego Rizzi, Alessandro Basso.
Ratini.
Et Gianluca Ratini. Pour la Belgique, on joue Dylan Alexandre, Logan Baton et Dieter Verplanken. Les scores Belgique-Italie 1-3. Dans le championnat féminin, demi-finale 1, on joue le pays, la France, contre la Suisse. Pour France, on joue Morgan Bacon, Anna Maillard et Audrey Bandiera. Et le score dans le jeu de la France contre la Suisse, 2-6. La France-Suisse, 2-6. Et la dernière demi-finale féminine, 2. C'est avec le pays d'Italie contre l'Espagne. Le score là, c'est Italie-Espagne 6-9. Theo, alle beterschap voor Nettie langs deze weg namens ons. See that the names of the Swiss team are typed in the chat window. Let me check if that's correct. Yeah. Thank you for updating, but indeed, names of the Swiss players, I forgot them, were Emile Mitterrand, Nicole Beggy, Elena Baumgartner, and Melanie Schubach. En leur coach, c'est Yvonne Schubach. Score féminin, France-Suisse, 5-6. Le score masculin, France-Danemark, 8-6.
Beeld is, dan kun je dat erop knallen.
We spelen nu allebei de andere kant op. Ja.
Ik zet die camera wel even de andere kant op, want het is sowieso lekker.
Yeah.
Zo, de Egypte, Denemarken, Sisbiet, contre la France, Dylan Rocher, championnat d'Europe, championnat du monde, championnat d'Europe, tir de précision. C'est un grand palmarès pour cet âge de Dylan. L'équipe Danemark joue très fanatique. Plus forte. The score of Italy, Spain, 7-9.
Кстати, мы его что упакуем?
Да, окей.
Ja, het is allemaal leuk om naar te kijken.
Met de French feminine women team. The arbiter, arbitre, referee, measuring. Some deliberation time for the coaches and players. Not playing bad at all yesterday against Italy. They almost won against Italy. So sure, every women team here has a chance of winning this championship. Till now, normally speaking, the French should win this with all the experience they got. All the experience the current players have, I should say. On the international level, but of course on the French level. Belgium taking the lead against Italy with the men. Belgium, Italy, 5-3.
Ik heb hier niet in
gekocht. Ja, België, Italië, bij
België. Wie? Die vrouwen aankopen?
ladies' game of Spain against Italy is a very good game. Both of the teams are playing very well. Current scores over there are 7-9. Italy-Spain, 7-9. Very well pointed by Dylan on the right side of the field with Efe, with effect over to the left side. Very well pointed. Of course, we know he can shoot, but we also know that he can point. It's one terrific player. Each time I see him play, I am more surprised about the qualities he's got. Very, very good player. The scores over there are 11-6. La France, 7-11-6 contre le Danemark. Avec Dylan Rocher. Very good shot from Diego. Italians against Belgium. Playing a good round here. Should be able to pick up some points. Three points for the Italian ladies against Spain, I think. Good score, 10-9. Italy-Spain, 10-9. Correction on the score on France-Denmark, 11-6. 11-6 pour la France contre Danemark. Et le féminin, la France contre la Suisse, 5-6. Et l'équipe de la Suisse en fait de 1, 2, peut-être 3 points, j'y pense. Franzosen klatschen auch ab. Jetzt ist es ein wichtiges Spiel. En zo, halffinale, kook me jetzt alle zu. Frankreich gegen Dänemark. Links hinten 11-6 für Frankreich. Und die Dänen waren 6-2 vor, auf jeden Fall. Franzosen zeigen jetzt auch einen Teamgeist. Nicht schlecht. 5-4. Le France bat Danemark 13-6. Qualifié pour la finale des championnats d'Europe. La France masculine. Dylan Rocher, Florent Coutançon et Williams Dauphin. Avec Logan Amouret, le coach P. Druel. Sorry for Denmark, but the French were better. And of course, France did not qualify for the finals yet. They need to win one double or one tête-à-tête. But they're halfway there. Ik zag hem niet.
Oh, hier ben je er wel. Je zit te schieten gewoon op bijna 10 meter. Hè?
Ja, ik denk dat het
Hier een beetje een foutje was je voor de coach om morgen te laten pakken. We gaan wel even
wachten. Ja, nu is het buiten naar links geprobeerd.
Wie?
Ja, nu is het buiten naar links.
Ja, precies.
Zo, mijn god.
Ja, cool, is dat hè?
Die komt echt niet. Nou, dat is niet echt. Ik denk bij de baan, zeg maar. Een pof raak.
Update on some of the scores by the ladies. Italy belt, Italy Spain. 11-9. La France contre la Suisse, 7-8. La France, la Suisse, 7-8. Et après le jeu de Diego Rizzi pour l'Italie contre la Belgique, le score est 7-4, 5-4. Mais the Italians have the opportunity to make 6 points here. 5 or 6 points. It's not so good for Belgium. Belgium's thinking about how they're going to solve this. So probably 5 points, but Belgium, Italy, 5-9. 5-9. Belgique contre l'Italie. C'est une bien mène pour l'Italie. L'équipe de Belgique n'a pas changé un joueur.
Ja. Of ik de teams kan verrassen met een uur zo'n minuut te spelen.
Dat gaan we niet doen.
C'est un point pour les femmes de France. C'est un pas bien point. La Suisse, après, va rester 3 boules contre 3 boules de la France. Good shot here from Logan Baton, premier tiré. Score 5-9 pour Belgique, Italie 5-9. Score dans le match féminin, Italie-Espagne, 11-10, 11-10 for the Italian ladies. For Italy are playing Laura Cardo, Giulia Levacchi and Jessica Rattini, playing against the Spain ladies. Melanie, Omar, Marta Fernandez, Cynthia, Araba, Diana Castro, hele coach Rafa Martos. Le score dans le jeu féminin de France contre la Suisse, 7-9. Un point pour la Suisse. Après une belle main première boule par l'équipe la Suisse. C'est une possibilité pour l'équipe d'Italie contre la Belgique et de jouer de fin 2-3 points. On a un score 11-12-5. So the Italians have the possibility here to make some points and increase their lead. And I really hope that the Belgium players will step up their game. So we can see a good match here between the Italians and the Belgium boys. And that's that. Diego made a terrific last shot here for 4 points. 13-5. 13-5 pour l'Italie.
Attends. Er zit hier zo'n wieltje, dan kun je hem lossen met draaien, zeg maar. Dan gaat hij makkelijk heen en weer.
Score is over at France against Switzerland, 7-9. Madame Bandera est dans le cercle pour un tir. Deuxième fois. Deux fois, tire un petit peu long à gauche. La première boule, tire une boule de Anna Meyer. Dankjewel. Feminin Italië komt er Spanje. Le score c'est 11-10. L'équipe d'Italie reste debout. L'équipe d'Espagne reste 0 boules. Point c'est pour l'Espagne. Mais c'est une possibilité de finir la joue contre l'Espagne pour l'Italie. Yeah, and again, some deliberation by the Italian ladies here. What's the best option? Not sure what's going to happen. She's going to take the shot. Encore, c'est une mine pour l'équipe de la Suisse contre la France féminine. Combien de points, je ne sais pas. Maintenant, le score 7-9. Points 7-11, 11-7 pour la Suisse. And Swiss ladies have really proven their stability this game, not making any big mistakes. Of course, the French ladies can play some ball, so they really have to be up their game, do what they were able to do, and then they'll have a chance. You see that in the current standings, 11-7, where the French ladies are a little messy, throwing some balls around that are not intended to throw them over there. Correct, the Italian ladies are not wearing the same t-shirt, so to speak. Two of the ladies are wearing some t-shirts and one of them is wearing a jacket. I think it's not that big of a problem, but that net looking the same. That's correct. So, scoring here on the ladies, Spain, Italy is 11-11. 11 partout par les équipes d'Italie contre l'Espagne. This is turning into a very interesting game here at Switzerland against France. The Swiss ladies really have an option here to win this triple and make it a big step. Into the finals. Very good opening for a second ball of the Swiss team. Very well pointed, and Audrey Bandiera will try to get the ball out of the way. Very good player. Good shot, but the ball isn't gone. So obviously not happy about it, but maybe good enough. Four balls against four balls. Quatre pour le reste pour la France et la Suisse. 7-11. The Swiss ladies are in the lead here, 11-7. Good shot here of the Swiss team. Three balls against three balls. Both of the referees watching the game between Italy and Spain, ladies. And the third referee is watching over by the other match of France against Switzerland. Would be a very big surprise here if Switzerland will win this triple from France. Getting close to a finish at the Italian-Spanish match, but it's obviously unclear which of the two countries is in the lead here. Both teams are playing very well. C'est une petite chance pour la féminine de France. Il fait 1-2 points. Oh, c'est très court. La dernière boule de la Suisse. C'est une chance de faire 2 ou 3 points pour la France. Anaïs Lapodje, Lapodier, Concentrating, Concentration, pour pointer le deuxième point. Il s'amène so to clarify the scores of your late joiners. Current situation is that the French team with Dylan Rocher won their game 13-6, and the Italian team won their game against Belgium 13-5. The French played against the team of Denmark, of course. And it's over. The Spain ladies won this game, 13-11. Very happy about it, also. 13-11 for the Spanish ladies. Un 11 est 11-8 pour la Suisse contre la Suisse. Yeah, the opening ball of Anna Meyer, not that great. Behind the cushioner, but good enough for the Swiss team to point the ball worse. So the ball on the left side is obviously the ball that has now the point for the French ladies. Second ball is a very good ball. Audrey Bandiere will try to shoot this ball. Very, very good. Carreau sur place pour Audrey. Et pour la France, Espoir féminine, championnat d'Europe 2013, demi-finale. Second shot of Audrey. Very good. Very good shot. Very good shot. Missed that on the camera because I was a little late in clicking. But I'm pretty new at this.
No.
Very good shot here. Third shot. French ladies are waking up. Swiss ladies need to think about what they're doing. Deliberation with the coach over on the left side. And they'll decide. Probably to point the ball in just for the point.
That's Jammer, yeah.
Not that great. It's a little bit, but it's point. It's over on the left side. Just went too long, just went over a little bit too long. Bien tiré par Anna Maillard. Trois points. Très important tiré par Anna pour trois points. Deux points, peut-être trois points pour l'équipe de France féminine. Yep, that's 3 points for France. 11 partout. C'est une très importante main maintenant. Le score 11-11. First opening ball again, a little long from Anna Meyer. Un petit peu mystérieuse. Parce que je ne sais pas pourquoi Anna joue très long. Very nice ball from the Swiss. sprinter. Nicole Big. Good shot, bien tiré par Audrey. Le point est retourné dans l'équipe de la France. Et 4 poules de reste pour la France. Cinq boules restées pour la Suisse. A little bit short. Very soft spot on the terrain. Too bad for the Swiss, but now the French will have the opportunity to shoot four boules out of the game, out of the lane, and then it will be over.
Beeld mee, dus dat kan niet.
Nee, maar de chat in de... Gaat dat tegelijkertijd met de band?
Nee, die chat is gewoon meteen.
Ja, er wordt ook gezegd, de chat is sneller dan de beeld, wat geloof ik.
Ja.
Wat rustig, als de langzaam ingevoerd.
Ja, dat is het.
Alright. Ja, ik zag het, ja. Oké. Scorings are 11-11. De cushion hebben over to the far left side of the lane. Anna Maillard. Pour la France. It's a little bit short, but okay. It's a little bit short here in the once again. A lot of pressure on Anish Lapouch. That probably is the point. Not too sure about that. Looks that's it. A little bit too long. So they're gonna play their last ball. Some deliberation with the coach. Players are coming to discuss this with the coach. What's the best option? Not sure about how many balls the Swiss team are left, but at least two. I think it's only two. So two bulls against one bull from France, and I think the point is for Switzerland right now. That went over to the right side too far. So the Swiss ladies, three bulls left. Trois boules pour la Suisse, pour pointer un point pour la victoire contre la France dans ce triplette. L'équipe suisse, on regarde de jouer à droite ou gauche. Il choisit de jouer à droite. C'est une surprise peut-être pour l'équipe de la Suisse de battre l'équipe de la France, peut-être. Et pour la Suisse, c'est une grande victoire. La boule, peut-être oui, peut-être non. Non, il n'y a pas là.
Donc, een beetje inzoomen op die middelste bol achterin. Die donkere, zeg maar, achter de muur. Oh. Verkeerde camera. Verkeerde camera. Digga, waarom gebeurt er niet? Ik had de verkeerde camera. Maar nu staat er nog.
Okay, last shot for the key team of Switzerland. If she gets this ball, the Switzerland team will win this match. It's a definite no-go. Now the Swiss ladies have to breathe in and breathe out, really easy, only 1 point, 12-11, but that obviously was a very, very, very big chance for the Swiss ladies. Difficult for them because they're playing against the team of France. They've played very well since then. And of course, it's possible that they not shooting every bull good. So obviously, it can happen. That's a very bad moment. That's also the moment with the biggest pressure. They gotta breathe in, breathe out. They know they're gonna have some other chances here to. Rodri Bandera, tire. Good shot, but the bull is still a point, so Anna Meyer will need to point her bull in. That ball, first shot of Audrey, ball went over the fence, so to speak. Went into the public, but luckily it didn't hit anybody. That's very difficult for the shooter of the Swiss team to shoot after she knows that she had a chance in winning this triple against France. And again, she misses. Can happen. The pressure is big. Pressure is a lot. She's gonna do it again. She's going to try to shoot once more. Allez, la Suisse. That's a very good shot. It's very good for her that she hit that ball. If she didn't hit it, it would be very difficult for the other players to save this match. Still is. Three balls left for France. Against three balls from Switzerland. Still is a very tight game. Just went over on the left side a little. And immediately the Swiss team has to be careful that they're not going to lose this match, lose the match in this round. Maybe normally speaking they should shoot two times so that the French only can make 2 points, 1 point. Pretty good decision here of the Swiss team. They're gonna shoot again. If they hit two times, the French will not be able to get 2 points. That's not good enough. That is just not good enough. Point is still with the French. Point still to the French. Only one ball for Switzerland. She can't do much. Only thing she can do is place the ball directly on the cushion. But when Audrey shoot this ball, the cushion will go out and the French only have 1 point. It's the only way they can save this, I think. Places it in point. Ball in front of the cushion, and the French only need to shoot this ball and point one in. But of course the other option is to point two balls in, because there is 1 meter space here to point the last two balls. But on this terrain with a lot of stones, possible that one of the balls will hit a stone and wander off. Here comes that first ball of Anaïs Lapouge. Bien joué. Et la dernière boule pour Audrey Bandiera pour la victoire contre la Suisse 13-12. Very, very fortunate here, the French, that they didn't lose that triple. That form last round here. Yes, that's good. The French win this game. 13-12. 13, 12 pour le France. Oi, oi, oi. Gonna take a little break here. Be back with you like 5 or 10 minutes or something for the broadcasting of the doubles and the triples, the doubles and the singles. Current situation is the ladies won, the French team won, and the Spain team won, by the men the Italian won, and the French won. So if all goes well, we'll be back in 5 or 10 minutes when we start the double and single round.